They put on their pants and panties just like us.
So, but what was the difference? That they saw a vision for their life, and then they, with the vision, you could create that plan and make that vision happen. But just think about your vision being so big, usually it scares you. If you've got the right vision for your life, you are scared squat.
Keeping it clean, PG.
But you're scared, like right now, heart beating, because everybody knows this is the first annual one, right? And those who know me for a long time know that this has been a vision for a long time. And I fought through that vision, and that vision has scared me to death and made me sit down. And then I'm sitting there going, okay, I can live an ordinary life. And then I'm like, nah, I can't. So many times people have said to me, when I kept meeting those bumps in the road, and they kept saying, well, maybe this is not for you. And I pondered that. I said, well, maybe not. Maybe, because who am I, right? I'm just a girl from Queensbridge. I'm a girl from the projects, okay? Grew up in the 50s, where black was, it turned beautiful, okay? But it wasn't always. And we're women, as women, we still are struggling to find our place and our acceptance in this world instead of. And so when I see this vision, what had to happen for me was I had to become something different in order to be here in front of you today. So when it talks about the manifestation of your vision, as you stay continued on that path of doing the things for your vision to come to manifestation. Right now, I'm looking at you guys. You are a manifestation of my vision. Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay? I mean, and y'all get to meet some chickens later, but there's those self-conversations that happen to us. Who do I get to become? I get to become the powerful woman that I am. Doggone it. That's why I wrote the book. Be powerfully from within. And that's actually where that came from. That's where that came from. Because I kept seeking my power outside of myself. I kept waiting for somebody to validate me. I kept waiting for somebody to give me a raise on the job or a pat on the back for all the hard work that I did. And when it didn't come, I feel like I didn't deserve it. Maybe that's why they didn't give it to me, because I didn't deserve it. So maybe I gotta work harder, you know? When we have the phrase, you know, especially, you know, sometimes we're being like, you gotta work twice as hard to get half as far, okay? So how do we get to that point where you enjoy the validation, but I don't need the validation anymore? And one of those things is, one of those ways is aligning your mind, body, soul, and spirit. Okay? Because when I kept trying to do it just through my mind, even though this is the mindset reset experience, when I kept trying to do it just here, it wasn't enough. When I tried to do it just like within my body, like trying to get up because everybody said, and I know Kim did a presentation before, she said, they said it. Well, who are they? But they said that I needed to get up at 9 o'clock in the morning to be ready to do my business. How are you going to do business if you don't get up early in the morning? I did that for like a year. I was freaking miserable. That's not who I am. It's my business. I get to choose. It's your life. You get to choose. You get to choose what your vision is. Because the vision, your individual visions, all of our individual visions, they fit into a bigger vision. And that's where the spirit